now that Samsung has officially confirmed that there is not going to be a Galaxy Note 21 series in 2021 due to acute shortages in chip supply, it now makes complete sense to me why Samsung had a separate Unpacked event for the launch of its new Galaxy A series smartphones. The new Galaxy A52 and the Galaxy A72 look like proper upgrades over last year's Galaxy A51 and A71. You're looking at a beefier system on chip, you're looking at a display with a 90Hz refresh rate, stereo speakers, IP67 rating, 3 years of assured software upgrades, and much, much more. Well, that does look impressive on paper. My name is Arshad, you're watching My Smart Price. This is our hands-on review of the newly launched Galaxy A52. But before we move on, don't forget to hit that red subscribe button and the bell icon right next to it to get notified whenever My Smart Price puts out an awesome new tech video. So what we have here is the Indian 4G variant of the Galaxy A52. So let's take a quick look at the unboxing and what you get inside the Indian retail box. I must say, this blue colorway on the Galaxy A52 is super attractive. I absolutely love the whole candy funk color aesthetic. This is a more confident approach to using plastic than trying to gloss it up and adding a faux metal sheen. The matte finish is an additional win for me. Plus, I love how the camera module is a machine-engineered bump that extends out seamlessly from the rear. It almost feels like a 3D printed plastic cutout. The placement of the camera rings on this module looks good too. Also, it feels solidly put together. Although I must say, I'm not a fan of that fake metallic frame. Moving on, the buttons are nice and clicky. You get a 3.5mm headphone port, a Type-C port, a hybrid SIM slot, and a speaker at the bottom that works in tandem with the earpiece in a stereo setup. I was surprised at the quality and the depth of sound. It does get pretty loud and sounds clean and crisp. The biggest new upgrade has to be the inclusion of the 90Hz refresh rate to the display. This is your same excellent Samsung Super AMOLED panel with super punchy colors and deep blacks. Plus, Samsung has upped the brightness levels in high brightness mode to 800 nits. This display can get really, really bright. HDR content on YouTube just pops and looks fantastic. Goes without saying that you get Vaido and L1 support as well. The touch response is pretty good too, although I would have liked it if Netflix played back HDR videos, which is not possible at the moment. Maybe an update will fix that, but I wouldn't count on it. The Samsung Galaxy A52 now comes with an upgraded 64MP camera with an f/1.8 aperture lens. The rest of the setup is the same with a 12MP ultrawide, 5MP macro and 5MP depth. Plus, you get a 32MP selfie camera as well. I did take a few shots with the phone in my limited time with it, and I think the selfies and portrait shots look fantastic. The images from the primary camera offer a good dynamic range in daylight with a very good color science as well. And the low light performance looks promising too, but we have to check that out in detail. The ultra wide angle camera and macros take pretty good looking pictures as well. So first impressions of the camera setup is very good. Let me know what phone would you like us to compare against the Galaxy A52 in the comments below. The Samsung Galaxy A52 comes with a Snapdragon 720G SoC inside and 6/8GB of RAM coupled with 128GB of storage. The 720G SoC inside the A52 is way better than the Exynos 9611 inside the A51 last year. Here's how much it scores on Antutu and Geekbench. Additionally, I did play 30 minutes of Call of Duty on the phone at high graphics and max frame rates, and it touched about 40 degrees by the end of the session. It was as smooth an experience as we've come to expect from Snapdragon 720G. I absolutely love the fact that Samsung is now committed to assured Android version upgrades. On the Samsung Galaxy A52, the brand has committed to 3 years of software upgrades and 4 years of security updates as well. And this phone comes with the latest Android 11 and One UI 3.1. One UI is one of my favorite Android skins out there. But yes, there are many bloatware apps pre-installed by default. I don't see a reason why Samsung has to pre-bundle apps like Moj and MX Takatak. Thankfully, you can delete all of them, so that's a good thing. More about the performance and software in my full review. Samsung has improved the battery capacity on the Galaxy A52 from the 4000mAh inside the Galaxy A51 to now a 4500mAh unit. And it comes with support for 25W fast charging as well. However, it is a pity that you only get a 15W charger inside the box. That I think is something that Samsung shouldn't have done. Now, Samsung claims that you can get 2 days of battery life on the Galaxy A52. Feels like a stretch, but we'll definitely test it out. So the Samsung Galaxy A52 is definitely looking like a very promising choice for a phone under ₹30,000. There are a whole host of updates that will compel even the older Galaxy A51 users to upgrade to this new phone. And considering the fact that this will be available offline, I'm expecting a lot of takers for this as well. In fact, the features that are there on the Galaxy A52 are also comparable to some online phones. Do let us know in the comment section below what phones would you like the Galaxy A52 compared against, and whether you want a review of the phone as well. Having said that, one of the things that I should mention is that there is no 5G version of the phone in our country at the moment. Also, it makes sense considering the fact that 5G rollout hasn't happened yet. So what do you guys think of the new Galaxy A52? Do let me know in the comment section below. Until next time, this is Aishar from My Smart Price signing off. Goodbye and Godspeed, my friends.